Hi everybody, my name's Tori. Today I'm going to be talking about scissor basics. At Christie's Direct, we stock a range of scissors with quality and budget to suit everybody. A general rule of thumb when purchasing scissors is to purchase the very best pair that you can afford. If you have a catalogue, you can use the little helpful icons beside each scissors to let you know at a glance what type of scissors you are buying. At Christie's Direct, we have a scissor indicator level, and this is made up of 5 levels. Level 1. This is an entry-level scissor for a start-up groomer or a student. Level 2. This is a workhorse everyday scissor for professional use. Level 3. This is a scissor for professionals that take scissoring seriously. Level 4. These are elite scissors made to an extremely high standard. Level 5. These are some of the best and most elite scissors in the world. They have a luxurious feel and a superior smooth cutting action. Adjusting your tension or balancing your scissors. This is a really important step in ensuring that you are getting the best results from your scissors. If the tension is too loose on your scissor, it will cause the hair to fold in between the blades. If the tension is too tight, it will cause a lot of unnecessary wear and tear to the blades of your scissors. One way that we would say to test for the tension on your scissors is to hold them facing up the way, so the top of the blade is pointing up. Then use your other hand to lift the other side of the blade to a 90 degree angle. When you let it go, if it falls completely closed, you know that the tension is far too loose. If it doesn't close at all, like it's doing here, the tension is too tight. So in this case, what we would say is this one here has an adjustable screw on it. So it's literally a case of trial and error. You would then go about twisting this little screw ever so slightly until you get that desired. What you're aiming for is for them to close 2/3 of the way. So not completely and not at all. So 2/3 of the way. So you just trial and error. So I've gone ahead and adjusted the tension until I find the perfect spot, and then I'm going to lift this side up, and when I let it go, it falls 2/3 of the way closed, and that's how you know you've got perfect tension. Now let's talk about storage. When your scissors are not being used, you should make sure that the blades are always kept closed. Never leave your scissors out sitting like this, because there is more chance of you getting nicks or damage to the blades, and therefore they will not perform to the best that they can. One thing that we would say is to never use magnets to hold or store your scissors. So never have a little thing on your wall with magnets to hold these up, because this will affect the magnetism of your scissors. In turn, this means that it's going to be attracting a lot of dirt and debris to stick to the scissors, and obviously you're not going to get the best results with that. What we would recommend is to get yourself some really nice storage for your scissors. So this is a storage cylinder, which is obviously designed for scissors. So it has little oodles on the top, which are really nice and soft. They're not going to scrape your scissor blades or anything like that. And you literally just slip them in. You can hold 8 to 10 scissors in one of these cylinders, and they are a really handy way to keep your sort of work area clean, keep your scissors really well maintained and looked after and safe. And they're also really easy to use and access as well. You can literally just pull them out and then pop it back in again whenever you're finished with them. Finally, we would say that scissors are a very personal thing, and because of this, we would recommend that you wouldn't let anybody else use your scissors. They are one of the most important tools in your profession, so just a way to kind of maintain them and look after them is just to not let anybody else use them. Point number 3, why clean and oil your scissors daily? Daily oiling and cleaning of your scissors will extend the life of them and the performance. Regular cleaning, lubrication, and oiling is going to be a perfect way to make sure there is no rust or deterioration of your scissors. Again, this means that they are going to last a lot longer and you're going to get the optimum performance from them. We would recommend to use a soft, clean towel to give them a wipe down between every cut. This is going to get rid of any sort of debris and buildup, and therefore deterioration, especially for the likes of any products or solutions that you're maybe using on the dog. After cleaning and drying your scissors, you should open them to a 90 degree angle and pop 2 little drops of oil in between the joints. This is just going to make sure that they're going to be nice and smooth to use. And again, it's going to keep the performance and sort of extend the life of your scissors. I really hope that that was beneficial in giving you some of the basics of how to maintain your scissors, and also a look into our scissor indicator.